switched up, and I just decided, I think I'm going to do broadcast meteorology. Again, great way to get information to the public and something that I can still do and still have my passion for. So I just went into broadcast. Mm-hmm. That's really a truly defining story there of how she actually got into weather. Jessica, yours started young with the love of snow, which you saw a lot of growing up in the New York City area.
Yeah, I feel like people know growing up, I loved it. I remember kind of looking out my window when I was a kid and seeing those big snow events and always waiting for school to get canceled and getting outside and playing in the snow. We have this big yard in my parents' home, and it would just get buried in snow, and we would make igloos out there and snowmen. It was always a great time and pretty awesome.
And now, Christina, you've actually been all over the place with your career from the West Coast to the East Coast. Tell us how you got started in the weather.
So my career has been backwards. You know, I didn't start loving meteorology. I didn't start loving TV, but I did start loving science. I'm the daughter of a science teacher. So I went to Girls in Science Camp every year growing up, mentors. But let's talk about some of the obstacles that we've had in the industry, because it certainly can be tough at times. I know personally I've had some bosses that have said, well, you're a woman, you actually can't get that job. Have you guys had any of those obstacles? In the beginning, just the curriculum, you know, my mother would take out the curriculum for Florida State and be like, have you seen all the math? And what is this? Get out there, get some help. Don't be afraid to ask for help, because going through all of that led me to becoming a meteorologist, and I wouldn't take that back for anything.
I grew up playing a male-dominated sport, going into a male-dominated field, and it is intimidating at times to say, you know what, you've just got to power through it, because there are expectations at times that are different for women. At least I feel that way. And, you know, it's kind of nice, like, for example, in thermodynamics, you know, calling my mom saying, Mom, I'm really freaking out. Like, this is really difficult. You know, I've got this one, you know, part of a lesson that I just can't grasp. And she'd just say, you've been doing this your whole life, whether you realize it or not. It doesn't matter, you know, what you've done in your past. Just know that you're working toward your future. And it's nice to have that kind of support from other women. And I feel like that's been one of the benefits, or a parent, or just somebody you work with on a daily basis.
Tomorrow,